What is Space Godzilla? It appeared as a bulkier, slower version of Godzilla, with navy blue skin and some patches of reddish purple skin. The area on its abdomen are smoother than the rest of the skin on its body. Because its body weight is so heavy, Space Godzilla cannot run that fast. Instead, it uses telekinetic powers to fly. As it flies around, its body becomes covered with many large crystals. Each shoulder has a massive white crystal, and its tail is longer, which ends with several crystal spikes. Space Godzilla was also known to be a little bit taller than Godzilla. The origins of Space Godzilla are very mysterious. Because Space Godzilla has some similarity to the original Godzilla, there is a theory that the original Godzilla cells were unknowingly carried into space by Mothra when it was going to deflect a meteor headed for Earth. Or even after Biollante was defeated, the Godzilla cells would travel to space on their own. Both theories led to those very same cells being exposed to a black hole. These cells would then mutate into a crystalline life form that came out of a black hole. Space Godzilla's design did hint at being linked to Biollante. They both had similar teeth, mouth design, tusks, and a slightly similar hissing roar. Space Godzilla had eyes and a crest on its forehead that was orange in color, almost similar to the color of Biollante's stomach area. The last feature they shared was that they both would turn into spores of light when they were defeated. The original design of Space Godzilla was supposed to look like a dragon with large fin-like wings on its back. Another design was given the name of Astro Godzilla, which was an albino Godzilla with large wings, two tails, and the ability to shoot an ice beam. There was even a design that made it into a quadrupedal creature, or even more like Biollante that commanded a horde of cosmic dragonflies. The last design was similar to the Super Nintendo game of Super Godzilla. In this game, Godzilla is able to reach a final form that does look similar to Space Godzilla. The horn on its head was a display of its power. It was supposed to have some type of radar ability. Another name that it went by was Crystal Godzilla. Even though it was just another monster, it was shown to be one of the most intelligent creatures to ever appear in the Godzilla universe. Unlike other creatures that are controlled by other beings, or those that are just on a mindless rampage, Space Godzilla actually sought to dominate the Earth, and this was out of his own free will. It was shown to also harvest power from a building, which converted Earth's core to an energy that Space Godzilla could absorb. It also showed strategic combat decisions when it trapped Godzilla's son inside a crystal prison. While being a very strong and intelligent enemy against Godzilla and Mogara, it did have a few weaknesses. Its very short arms would limit its options in melee combat, so it had to rely on ranged attacks like its Corona Beam. While the massive crystals on its shoulders are linked to its power, destroying these crystals will also make it weaker. These crystals were seen to not withstand much damage, and its skin was not that resistant to Godzilla's red atomic breath. Now, I wanted to look at Space Godzilla because it's one of my favorite villains alongside King Ghidorah. There's also another creature that I like a lot, which I will save for another video. So that covers Space Godzilla. Are you a fan of this creature, or do you have another favorite? Put it down in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like rating on it, and stay tuned for more videos around the Godzilla universe. Thanks for watching. My name is Carlos, and I'll see you in the next video.